Evening all, we're going to start this market update. What's up next on the market? Let's start this presentation. Please feel free to ask all the questions that you have through the chat that we use. Today's agenda, quick market review. What's next? What's happening on the next days? So what is the agenda of the week and the month? Key events, chart of the week, and then we switch directly on our MetaTrader platform to check what's happening on real time and looking at the level, the support and resistance level we have on the charts. The format is expected to last around 20 minutes, but this is also up to the question that you have. My name is Stefano Gianti. I am education manager for Swissquote Bank. We are a world leader in online trading. This is my email if you need further information after the presentation. Of course, yes, I can share with you, as Alan was asking, I can share with you the PDF of this presentation, and the video will be uploaded tomorrow morning on our YouTube, so you can check Swissquote channel on YouTube. Stefano.gianti@swissquote.com is my email, just in case. Gan is asking information about this appointment. Now we're doing this market update, this market commentary right now, and the idea is that from April we're going to start to do it on a weekly basis in different languages. So quick market review. Rising optimism, geopolitics improve, yet economic data disappoint. What is good is the discussion between China and the Chinese and the American administration is going pretty well. We're waiting to get more information regarding a new possible deal, but this deal has been delayed, the deal about the tariffs, and the expectation of a trade deal we have now in mid-March 2019. So we can have more information in the next days. But yet, there is still a lot of optimism. And so for this reason, the Standard & Poor's went up in the last weeks. So this is very important to notice. The summit between Trump and Kim Jong-un was, let's say, unsuccessful. There was no joint statement at the second summit and no further summits planned. So there was not at all a good compromise for the two administration between the US and the North Korean one. What's very important this week is the economic politics from, we will receive more information from the European Central Bank on Thursday. You know, there is the press conference of Mario Draghi. Anyway, let's start to discuss about the Federal Reserve. Federal Reserve is patient before further tightening. So what's changed a lot in the last months was the expectation about the tightening in the US. You know, we already have a different interest rate increase in 2007, in 2018, one in 2017, three in 2018, and it was expected to have three in 2019 this year, but after November it changed a lot, this expectation, and now it is also likely that there will be no interest rate increase over this year. And it is also likely that there will be an interest rate cut at the beginning of 2020. So the expectation, the forward guidance changed a lot in the last months from Federal Reserve. This is also up to the other central banks, because also the Reserve Bank of Australia and the Reserve Bank of New Zealand, they say that they don't have... they are not willing to increase the interest rates in the next months. So also the Federal Reserve change is on forward guidance. And there is a new concern over inflation below the target of 2%. As you can see in this slide, the December PCE deflator on a yearly basis was at 1.7%. So was lower than the prior data of 180%, and anyway lower of the 2.0% that the Federal Reserve also wants. This is more important for the European Central Bank to have the inflation near the target, near but below the target of 2%. You know that the target of the Federal Reserve is slightly different because they want to focus more on the growth of the gross domestic product, but inflation anyway is still important. So the target is not reached. So also for this reason, the probability to have an increase of rate in the next months at the moment is pretty low. Bad information from US, we had the January personal income in negative territory for the first time in more than 3 years. So the expectation was for a growing of 0.3%. The data release was minus 0.10%, so in negative territory. What is the impact on euro dollar? Is asking Alfred in the chat. We are going to check the charting in some minutes. Let's go ahead with the market review for now, and then we'll go directly to the MetaTrader to check all the charts, and feel free to ask all the questions that you have, please. Also, of course, during the presentation. Eurozone, soaring economic outlook, manufacturing PMI in contraction territory for two consecutive periods, and slowdown in February core inflation. Also, in our market outlook regarding 2019 that we publish on our website, that is Swissquote. .com. We already said that we expected a slowdown on the manufacturing in 2019 and 2020. So we had some confirmation that the manufacturing is slowing down in Europe, in the Eurozone. This is a confirmation of the what we really expected. Anyway, next is Brexit. GBP, the pound, last week was on the rise over Brexit optimism, but the risk of no deal still vivid. Key votes in the coming 2 weeks. Last week, the cable rose 175%. On a week-to-week day, on a week-to-date basis, in this in the platform now, this is our MetaTrader. This is a script where we can see all the performance of the different currencies on a daily, weekly, monthly basis, or if you want, you can also use different time frames. We can see that so far the best currency pair in this month, this is a monthly one, is anyway USD CAD, and then we have OC dollar against Canadian dollar. So we can say that CAD is pretty weak, it's very weak this month. Then we are going directly to the chart, and on a weekly basis, starting from the opening session of Sunday night so far, USD CHF is the best performer so far. And the cable, you see, the cable here, this is where I want to focus your attention. The cable, after being the best performer last week, has been is so far the worst performer so far this week. We can just click on the chart, and then we can go to the technicals also on this different chart. It is more clear, so we can go straight away on the cable. But also on the slide, let's start with the slide, and then we come back to the platform. This is very interesting. Downward pressures looking ahead. This is there is a bearish channel starting from this level 143.77. It was the spring of last year, and then we added this downward channel going ahead. 124.41 now is the most important support level of a long term, because it has been touched two times. 127.73 is the minor resistance level so far, but what is very important, if we go back to the chart again on our MetaTrader 5 platform, is that we can just use a trend line. You see we had these two highs. The second high was higher than the first one, but now the trend changed quite a lot. And this is also related to the strength of the USD in this moment, in the last 2 days. And regarding this, of course, it will be very important to follow the press conference of Mario Draghi that will be having a major impact on the euro dollar, but of course also on the other currencies with the euro and either the dollar. And so far, we have these two highs, the second highs higher than the first one, but now the previous high has been touched again. So this former support level now is again a resistance level. And what there is here in this slide of this presentation is also the 200-day moving average. As you can see, this is a dynamic support level at the moment, is 129.90. So it is a very likely target for the next days. 129.90 is the target on GBP USD. So still we have potentially 200 pips. But this is to monitor also this level that I'm highlighting now on the platform, 130.53. is another support area, okay? But be careful, because we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 red candles consecutive on the cable right now. What's next regarding the Brexit? So let's go back to the presentation. Further UK House of Commons debates plan in March. The first date is the 12th of March. So, the second vote on a revised withdrawal agreement. If the deal will be rejected, just in case, the day after, the vote on the motion to leave the European Union without a deal. And if the motion will be rejected again, the day after, the 14th of March, there will be a new vote on the motion to delay Brexit beyond 29 March 2019 deadline, that is in 23 days only, okay? But be careful to this, because in case the European Union requires to approve in meetings between the 21st and 22nd March summit. So these days are very important to monitor, just in case the House of Commons, they will be not finding any agreement. The next dates to monitor will be the meeting of the 21st and 22nd March summit during the for the European Union. Okay. Our idea regarding the behavior of the pound is that the GBP will go up only if there won't be a hard Brexit. Okay, so very negative. The worst scenario for the cable and for the GBP, for the pound itself, will be a hard Brexit without postponing the deadline of the 29 March. Okay, can you say again the level on the cable? Is asking Alfred. I'll go back to the chart right now. So, trading opportunities on the cable. We have so far this horizontal channel. For this reason, I draw this resistance level and this support level, because now we have this former support 132 area. This is the area. What I do usually in order to have a best precision on a daily chart is that I use the linear chart that is highlighting only the closure and not the high and the low of the candle. And then I just highlight the support level. So this was the former support level, and now it is a resistance level 132.06.07 area. That is also the top of today's candle. So this is the area. And the support level that now is very important is 130.53, 130.60, this area here. Okay. This is very important to follow for the next days. And also, if we can draw this Fibonacci retracement, just to show you with in this way. Clicking with the right button, then let's change together the color. So I show you properties. Then you switch to the, let's change the color a little bit. And also properties again, parameters, levels, and let's go for this. If we go to see, this is 61% of Fibonacci level that usually is a very strong support area, is 129.48. Where is the 200 periods moving average? Is nearby that level, 129.90. So we have a different support nearby for the GBP USD that potentially they are different targets that we can have on this short position. Mark Carney, the Bank of England governor, the drop in business investment due to Brexit will hamper the UK economy. Has been a slowdown in the UK economy in the last years. Regarding the growing of the GDP, yes, definitely. The inflation rose a lot. So, of course, the uncertainty over the Brexit and the deadline is still important. So everybody is looking to get more information regarding the what the outcome of the next days from the UK Parliament. So Brexit volatility not fully priced in. The pair is trading within donor trading channel and a retracement along resistance at 127.73. That was the level of the 14th of February. Is our target at the moment. Okay, so we saw the different support levels. This Thursday is very important because there will be the European Central Bank rate decision. There won't be any changes in the rate guidance. Targeted long-term refinancing operation likely. Cut in economic forecast is expected. So there is a weak rate hike probability for 2019. Mario Draghi could be the first president of European Central Bank that never increased the interest rate. So there will be a further pressure for the euro. So let's go on the MetaTrader. Let's go back on the MetaTrader. Also to answer to Alfred's question before regarding euro dollar and the most important level to monitor. We have, first of all, on euro dollar, this is a daily chart. This is the trend line taking the first high, the second and the third. You see, this is perfect trend line. To draw a perfect trend line, as I said before, usually on a daily chart it's better to use the linear chart. So you just have the closing of the candles, not the high or either the low, okay? And we are very near to different support levels. So let's use the horizontal line now, support level, starting support level. The first, the most important now is 112.56, that potentially is the target of this bearish movement. And the first one, you see, the first target has been reached, let's say now, during our webinar. So 128, 1.1288 is the first support level that has been touched today. So now eventually we have to monitor what's going to happen in the next hours, because on these support areas, if we will find a reversal pattern, could be the case to open a long position. The target of a long position now could be just this trend line. So on a daily chart is now the price of this trend line according to the time that the price will go in that direction is anyway 1.1340 area. What you don't have to do, never, never, never do it, is to open a long position when the market is still bearish in this way, because you see the momentum is still high. What is your favorite momentum indicator? Was asking Paul. This is a very good question. MACD, moving average convergence divergence, is an indicator. We are going to speak about anyway indicator and oscillator of momentum during this month. I will show you the calendar of our next webinars. And then there is the stochastic. You can find stochastic in indicators, oscillators, and then you have stochastic. Usually I use 14.3.3. Okay. It's a very common one. So, yeah, this is a very good question, Paul. If you use a stochastic, you see there was this overbought condition on the stochastic. The stochastic is the blue line, the red line is the moving average of the stochastic itself. So, this is perfect for technical analysis. Bearish trend line, stochastic, and then reversal pattern like a pin bar, okay, like this one. We had two consecutive candles with a very long shadow and a very tiny body. Anyway, we're going to speak about technicals during our webinars. I also have this slide related to our webinars, swissquote.com/webinars. Next will be about rebalancing of Bitcoin. The 19th of March, we'll speak about technicals. So, the 1-2-3 pattern of Joe Ross, that is a very famous US trader. And the 26th of March, we will have another webinar, the most famous and effective momentum oscillators and indicator. So, we're going to explain the stochastic, the relative strength index, the CCI, ADX, and MACD. Okay. So feel free to ask anytime if you have if you need to get more information before. This is my email, stefano.gianti@swissquote.com. We still have to speak about China. I wanted to have this format of 20 minutes, but maybe it's impossible for me to speak at 20 minutes only. But okay, again, US China trade talks will remain a key factor on the marketplace for sure. Expectations for now are on a positive scenario. Let's say our deadline for a deal is by mid-March 2019. What I want to show you now is what happened to China. I think this is very, very important. I use trading economics right now to show you this. We also use trading economics in one of the lessons of mastering trading. Just to let you know, and if you want to get more information, you can visit our YouTube website, YouTube channel, just typing Swissquote mastering trading on YouTube. Anyway, we also have a playlist. You can ask me by email. We had a series of 8 webinars called Mastering Trading, starting from the basic of Forex, what is leverage, how to use the platform, and then going through all the information. We also spoke about fundamentals, technicals, and macroeconomics in this case. And we describe trading economics as a very nice website to check information about the economic calendar and other information about the the economic activity. Okay. Anyway, this is the Shanghai Composite Stock Market Index. And what happened since the inception of the year? That a lot, a good level of money inflow came to this market, to China, to the Shanghai Composite Index and China in general. Before telling you why, I want to show you another very important chart. Are you ready to watch this very important chart? I'm just cleaning all the chart for now. So just removing the indicator, the trend line, and the objectives. This is one of the most important charts on the market. Maybe you don't hear a lot from CNBC about this, or Bloomberg or other televisions, but in my opinion, my personal opinion, this is my personal opinion, this is one of the most important chart in order to have a balanced economy. If you remember, years ago, there was in 2015, if I'm not wrong, there was the crisis of the Chinese renminbi, and the market went down. It was the end of August 2015 and then the beginning of January 2016. If you remember. If you don't remember, I can show you. Okay. What happened? What happened that there was this huge movement at the beginning of the year in 2016? And the depreciation. This was a very strong, very fast depreciation of the Chinese yuan, of the Chinese currency, of the renminbi, okay? And if you remember what happened in January 2016, the markets, Standard & Poor, Nasdaq, and other indexes, they fell down 20-25%. Because there was an intervention on open market on the Chinese currency from the Popular Bank of China. Okay. Now their policy, they are not doing anymore this kind of intervention on the open market, and their policy changed a lot. Anyway, in 2018, there was a huge market outflow from China simply because the Chinese renminbi was depreciating a lot. You see, this was the low of 2018, 623. This is the high of end 2018, November, 698. And you see the huge movement. Now what's happening? It's happening that the renminbi is appreciating. This is good for the Chinese economy. The question, the answer could be maybe not, because everybody knows that China, over the time, they always wanted to have a pretty weak currency in order to export more. But the point is that after the market outflow in 2018, now, for Chinese authorities, it's better to have a change in this policy and to try to have a strong renminbi to, in order to produce a flow of capital that is entering the Chinese economy. And of course, on the other side, there is also an outflow on the capital from the United States. This outflow, of course, is still in place. It started at the beginning of the year, as you can see from the chart before, with also all this capital inflow going directly to the Chinese shares. And of course, for this reason, to the Chinese, for this inflow in the Chinese economy, the renminbi is appreciating. What's next is pretty difficult to say if this this momentum will go ahead for different time. Because this is what the Chinese authorities they want at the moment. But you see, the speed of the appreciation of the renminbi is still strong. The momentum is still strong. Now, we are very near. We are on a support level. This is a very important support level. So if you want to trade USD CNH, that is the Chinese renminbi, this is a weekly chart. We are now on the 61.8% of the Fibonacci retracement. 6.6981 is the level. The price now is 6.7113. What is the leverage on USD CNH is asking George. If you click on the product with the right button and then you click on a specification on the drop down menu just to show you the platform, you have all the information regarding the products, the also the hours, the trade time from 11:30 starting from Sunday night to 22:55. This is Central European time, so it is GMT plus one to Friday.
Yes.
Okay, so you can trade USD CNH almost 23 almost 24 hours a day, but be careful because there are breaks between 22:55 to 23:30. So you have these 35 minutes of market close. Okay, just bear in mind, just to show you how you can watch all the information from the platform, okay, directly. And then you have the swap long, the swap short, okay, the 3-day swap that is on Wednesday, as all the other currencies. And then when you open an account with the Swissquote Bank, you can choose the leverage that you want. When you open the account, the standard leverage is 100, but if you want, you can ask to your account manager if you want to get more information. Please bear in mind that our email is fx@swissquote.com, just to give you the information. Gan was asking before, do they will get an agreement with the US on renminbi? It's not a real agreement. It's like a silent agreement. I mean, the agreement in case will be on the tariffs. This will be the direct agreement. But anyway, the Chinese will be the first beneficiaries of this silent agreement with the United States. Okay, so it is also good to stabilize the capital market. So having a USD CNH currency rate between these levels in this area, for me, the optimum for the economies, the two different economies and the global itself, will be having a USD CNH inside this area, let's say towards 660, okay, will be perfect. What will be very difficult, you see, the movement of the last weeks on this currency. So what will be very difficult in the next months is that the USD CNH pair will stabilize over this level 660. So this will be pretty difficult to monitor. Okay. Anyway, for now, it's very important to say that the Chinese authorities has the commitment to have this strong renminbi. At the moment, it's very needed. Okay, so if you don't have any question, fx@swissquote.com is our email. Why trade Forex with Swissquote? Because we have more than 20 years of online trading expertise. We are trusted by more than 320,000 traders worldwide. We have multilingual customer support. We have global liquidity and precise execution. We are an international group listed on the SIX Swiss exchange. And the date of the 8th of March, that will be this Friday, for us it is an important day because there will be the press conference of our CEO, Mark Burki, and Paolo Buzzi regarding the result of 2018. That was a record year for SwissQuote. We increased our revenue of 16% respect to last year. So I will also update this information afterward. So at the moment, this is our annual trading volume over 1 billion and 25.5 billion of CHF assets under custody. So I'm showing you this slide because it's very important to have a bank as a counterpart. You can trust also in the solidity of the bank with a capital ratio of 27.5% and a total equity over 300 million. So we are beyond the highest Swiss banking standard. If you want to get more information regarding this today's presentation, do not hesitate to contact me writing an email to my email stefano.gianti@swissquote.com. If you want to get more information about our services, please feel free to ask. You can call us +41 44 825 8777 or write an email to fx@swissquote.com, or you can chat with us to speak about our services. Just connecting to swissquote.com, and then you have the live chat open on the right button on the website. So thank you very much for joining this presentation. Thank you very much. See you next time. Anders, best regards from Sweden. Bye, have a good evening. Thank you for the webinar, Gan. Thank you very much for joining this webinar. Thank you, Oleg. Thank you all. Have a good evening. Bye-bye. Take care.